Eric Zurrin from Shanta Gold's back with me in the studio today. Eric, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Q3 update, another strong quarter for you. Eric, just remind us what you've been up to.
So we produced 22,700 ounces in the quarter. It was our second best quarter over the last 2 years. Most remarkably, were our cash costs down at below $500 an ounce. And that generated into $16.5 million of EBITDA for the quarter. So again, a fantastic result. The upshot here is the balance sheet continues to repair itself. We've now repaid another $5 million in the quarter. Net debt's down by $6 million in the quarter. And we're headed on the way to a net cash position sometime, hopefully next year.
How have you managed to achieve such competitive, if you like, cash costs here?
I think I put it down to the way we incentivize the team. You know, the way we put the right people in the right places, have the right skills, and keep a very close eye on cost management and capital allocation. So as my background's in finance, and I make sure as a shareholder, I'm seeing dollars spent in the right places.
Well, it certainly appears as though you're tracking to hit comfortably your full year production targets.
Yeah, yeah. And we are. We're on track for 80,000 to 84,000 ounces. I imagine if you did the math yourself, you'd probably think 80,000 would be a pretty poor Q4. But at the moment, there's no surprises expected in Q4, and we're tracking for that guidance.
What's happening on the exploration front?
Well, that is the most exciting pillar of our value story by far. Every year of mine life, we add. Every 80,000 ounces of additional ounces into our mine plan contributes $60 million of EBITDA at the current gold price. So what do you know? That's where we want to spend the most money. And this year we've spent just shy of $1 million on exploration drilling. I'm trying to do a bit more than that next year, which is, in comparison, not very much money compared to our cash flow. And we've got the targets now. It's we did this work over the last year or two. Came up with a top 25 list, and now we're literally going through one by one systematically the best targets and coming up with some encouraging results.
And so rig's turning at these three initial key targets at the moment.
Absolutely, yes. These are on the mining licenses in Luika, Bahenia Creek North, Elizabeth Hills North, and Bahenia Creek Deep West, which is where we had really encouraging results in July. We put out another set of results in about 2 weeks ago. Encouraging widths, 4 to 9 meters wide, good grades, believe it was about 4 to 8 grams per ton. And so this gives us all this momentum. And what we want to get to is ultimately resource and then ounces into the mine plan and a reserve. And that's, for us, it's on the horizon.
Well, how soon would you like to have a resource for these targets here?
Before the end of the year or maybe sooner?
Right. How are you finding things, generally speaking, in Tanzania at the moment?
Well, it's a breath of fresh air having Barrick Gold now in country. Just to remind you, Shanta is the third largest gold producer. Barrick's the first. Anglo Gold's the second. And there's little old Shanta, the third. But we're in very good company. I've personally been talking to Barrick quite a bit over the last few weeks since they've come into the country. And it's encouraging to hear their philosophy and hearing about their playbook for Africa. These guys are serious operators, very experienced on the continent. And, the walls were just closing in on occasion. So it's great to see that a Barrick has come through.
Well, the encouraging direction, as you put it, of travel here as far as the operating environment. What might this mean? And we have spoken about it in the past. But your VAT and that cash owing, are we any closer to a decision on that or knowing more?
First and foremost, Barrick must resolve the outstanding issues with the government of Tanzania. And I read what they disclose publicly, and it seems like they're having good conversations on that. So let's look for that catalyst first. That would probably be something to do with this tax liability, something to do with the concentrate ban, and possibly their own VAT under this 50-50 framework. Now, I don't know, I'm not an insider there, but we encourage and we hope as a stakeholder in Tanzania. For us, what does it mean? Well, we've always said that Acacia Barrick, or now Barrick, needs to be the catalyst for normalization in country. And our only complaint, so to speak, is a VAT receivable that is not refunded. We have open dialogue with the government. There's nothing new that we know that tells us we're not gonna get a refund, but it's just slow and it takes a process. So we're encouraged and we're patient. But we're certainly focused on the prize.
And what is your potential prize here? It's nearly 30 million.
It is, yes. Okay. Yes. And we, you know, we've always believed that this would come in installments and in pieces. And you know, we'll have to wait for the outcome. But as I said, there's nothing to suggest that we don't believe it's coming.
Well, that would certainly be transformational for you.
It would be transformational, yes. Yeah, the amount of questions I've had to ask about VAT or answer about VAT over the last few years has been I've lost count.
Mm. Yeah. But what about Singida? How's the IPO moving?
Well, in the quarter, we've resubmitted our prospectus to the government, to the regulator. So we're on track. As I said, you know, previously, Singida is a great milestone for Shanta because it takes us over the 100,000 ounce production threshold. We want to see Singida built. The government wants to see Singida built. The stakeholders of Singida want to see Singida built. So this is a tripartite, you know, everyone working together. But things do move at their own pace in Africa, so we just must all be patient.
Have you considered dividends at all? Is that something on the agenda at some point?
Well, it's funny you ask that because we get a lot of questions from our shareholders about that exact point. Now, as we generate cash and repay the debt, then naturally the question then is what next? So it is, you know, it is something that we need to address, and you know, we'll be talking about that with the board probably over the next couple of months too, on you know, in terms of what we want to do and what our options. But there's no commitment for now. But it is certainly it's an obvious question, not that belittling that, but it is a natural question to be asked.
But look, but speaking of cash and earnings, we can't remember if we actually touched on it right at the start of our conversation, but Q3, what did you have? 16 million.
16 and a half
million. Which was a nice increase on Q2.
Correct, yes. $16.5 million of EBITDA. I mean, it's fantastic. We were enjoying the higher gold price, very good production, and containing the costs. You know, it's a really good moment over the last 90 days for Shanta.
And all on track as far as Q4 is concerned, given it's still early days?
On track, yeah. Yeah, we're now 17 days into the quarter. You know, I've seen nothing that's, you know, it's literally kind of on track day by day. So we're you know, we're hopeful we'll get to where we need to be.
Well, hopefully we'll see you soon.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, thank you.